Now we have a feeling on the quantity of energy. But how do we store energy? To explain this, we have to look into energy carriers. Energy is contained in what are called energy carriers. By definition, an energy carrier is a substance or a phenomenon that contains energy. This energy can then be converted to mechanical work or heat, or used to operate chemical or physical processes. We have encountered different types of energy. As we move from one energy form to another, the energy carrier changes. The most common energy carriers contain chemical energy. Fossil fuels are a good example of chemical energy stored in coal or natural gas. Chemical energy is also stored in plant matter, including wood. Gases such as hydrogen and ammonia are also being developed as new energy carriers. The synthesis of these gases stores energy within the chemical bonds of the molecular structure and can be transported as a fuel. Lastly, the most well-known energy carrier that we all use every day is the food that we eat. Like chemical energy, mechanical energy can also be contained within energy carriers. A dammed reservoir is the best example where the potential energy of water is contained and can be used to generate hydroelectricity. Mechanical energy can also be stored in pressurized air and recovered by releasing the pressure. In a somewhat similar manner, cold springs and flywheels can also store mechanical energy. Electrical energy is perhaps the most commonly used form of energy in our daily lives. A dynamic carrier for electrical energy is electricity itself, which can be used to produce heat or work. Electricity has a very high exergy, since almost all the energy can be directly used to do work. Batteries are static electrical energy carriers. The energy is actually stored chemically, but released as electricity. Similarly, capacitors can also store electrical energy inside their electric fields. However, the amount of energy that can be extracted is very small compared to a battery. Thermal energy is more challenging to store, owing to the high rate of heat dissipation. Concentrated solar power plants use mirrors and lenses to focus the solar radiation and heat up a liquid. Molten salts are generally used to store heat, as they are much more efficient than water. The heat leaking from the Earth's core is trapped inside the crust of the Earth in thermal reservoirs. This is known as geothermal energy, and can be considered a thermal energy carrier as well. Finally, steam generated from heating water has been used as the energy carrier to drive the pistons of steam engines since the 19th century. Most energy carriers can be traced back to the energy of the sun in one way or another. Solar energy, in a way, is the principal form of energy on Earth. It can be converted into heat and electricity, which are the two major energy carriers used to perform work. Solar panels convert solar energy directly into electricity, while the heat radiated by the sun can also be used directly. Thermal energy can also be used to generate electricity in thermal power plants. Solar energy is stored chemically in a plant matter via photosynthesis. Biomass can be used to provide both heat and electricity. Biomass that has been compressed under the Earth's crust for thousands of years is converted into fossil fuels. Fossil fuels can again be used to generate thermal and electrical energy. The sun and the moon are also responsible for the Earth's climate and tides. Solar energy makes the winds, move and perpetuates the water cycle that gives the rise to rain, rivers and lakes. Both the wind and the water contained in rivers and lakes can be used to generate electricity. Most forms of energy that we use are thus derived from solar energy. The energy from the sun is converted and stored in different ways on Earth. But how much energy is contained in the different carriers we know? We can express this in terms of energy per kilogram of fuel stored. For example, gasoline has an energy content of 12.4 kilowatt hours per kilogram. In comparison to this, another important fossil fuel, natural gas, has an energy content of approximately 12 kilowatt hours per kilogram. When we compare these fossil fuels to compressed hydrogen, we can see why there is so much ongoing research in the hydrogen field, as it has a very high energy content of 39.5 kilowatt hours per kilogram. Now you have an idea of the energy content of some of the most important energy carriers. This will help you estimate energy quantities from renewable energy sources and make you able to compare them.